What's up, guys? Welcome back to my channel. Today's topic is going to be about reapplying to medical school. I know it is absolutely the worst feeling when you prepare a full medical school application and you don't get any interviews. And if you did get interviews, you did not get into any medical schools. So now that means that you have to reapply. And I was in that situation and I got admitted on the second round of applications. If you are in this situation, do not fret. Be nice to yourself and allow yourself to identify what were the shortcomings in your last application and address them properly and adequately. There are four things that you should be doing for your next application. First, identify your weaknesses. Second, improve them. Third, reapply, possibly with even more schools and a more variety of schools. And fourth, apply early as you can. First of all, to prevent this from all happening in the first place, only apply when you're fully convinced that you have done absolutely everything to have the best application possible. For example, in my first application, I knew that my MCAT score was far below optimal, and I probably should not have applied. But I did it anyways, hoping that I would just get lucky. And that costed me thousands of dollars in application fees, secondaries, and also a lot of time. Quick side note, a lot of schools, but not all, will send you secondaries just because they want to collect the secondary application fee. So my first time around, I received some secondaries from schools that I knew I had no chance in because of my MCAT score. But I paid the fee and submitted my secondary anyways, just hoping that something would happen. Now, if you have applied and did not get accepted to any medical school or did not get any interviews like me, then first thing you should do is look at your entire application objectively and identify where it is weak. Perhaps it is your MCAT score, GPA, essay, lack of valuable activities, etc. You can also ask for professional services and help or consultants that can help you identify your weak points in your application. Just do a quick search on Google for help on medical school applications and you'll see tons of services like Med School Insiders, BMU Academic Consulting, and etc. Also, you can contact the schools themselves that have rejected you to seek feedback at the end of the application cycle. You can get on a phone call with the dean or assistant dean of admissions who will look through your entire application and give you specific guidance on your weaknesses. For example, they may identify that you were very awkward during your interview and that you exuded way too much nervousness, or they may suggest that you need a better personal statement. Maybe it wasn't convincing enough to the admissions committee on why you want to become a physician. By the way, I made a video on personal statements. You can click here for that. Regardless of your weaknesses, just know that you can improve your application. Whether it be an objective thing like MCAT score or GPA, or a subjective thing like interviews. Now, once you have identified your weaknesses, work like hell to improve them. If it is MCAT, study for MCAT again and retake it. If it's GPA, consider doing a master's program and do extremely well to show the admission committee that you can handle the academic load. If you weren't very good at interviewing, do some mock interviews and get better at them. If your activities weren't impressive, do more quality activities, volunteer more, shadow more, do research, get better letter of recommendations from those activities, improve your application, become a better applicant. Bottom line, make your application better by just being better. Be a better applicant. Now, once you're ready for preparing your second application, I suggest you only change what you improved on. Disclaimer, this is my opinion only, and I'm just a random guy on YouTube with no adcom experience, But hear me out. In my case, on my second round of applications, the only differences from my first application was a better MCAT score and some additional hours completed in a hospital. Everything else was the same for me. All essays, activity descriptions, secondary application essays were the same for me. I did not change a single word. Was it out of laziness? Yes, to some extent, but also because I knew my essays were strong, and I frankly did not know how to make them any stronger, so I did not change them. Some people do suggest that you change the essays around, but I frankly thought that my essays were strongest that they ever could be. And I applied to practically all the same schools as my first time around with the same exact essays, and I got interviews and I got accepted to all the schools that I interviewed in. It came to a point that I had to start declining interviews. So again, in my opinion, I don't think you need to change your essays around for your primary and secondary application if you really think that they're already super strong. Again, this is my opinion only, and you should do your own research on what you want and should do. Just be comfortable with whatever decision you pick. All I'm saying is that it worked out for me, and odds are that it will work out for you too. I just can't imagine the AdCom actually caring or having the time to compare applications from different years to see if you were actually too lazy to change essays. Again, just my opinion. Now, regardless of which application service you use, AMCAS, ACOMAS, or the TMD SAS, they will ask you if you are a reapplicant and to explain what you did to improve your application. In this space, you should just answer the prompt. Explain what you did in that gap year. For example, I talked about the fact that I continued my full-time job as an Army engineer, deployed for 2 months, studied and retook my MCAT, did 50 hours of hospital PACU volunteering, finished more of my prereq courses, and started a YouTube channel. Essentially, your response should show that you are not lazy and that you are a hardworking, productive individual. You should show that you are different than the average person. You did not spend months just lazing around on your couch watching Netflix all day and all night. You need to show that you are diligent and fruitful with your time, because that is how you need to be in medical school. Next, consider applying to more schools and different kinds of schools. If you only apply to AMCAS MD schools, perhaps consider applying to DO schools and maybe even some Caribbean schools. At the end of the day, you're learning nearly the same content in every school you go to, and you'll eventually become a doctor no matter which school you get out of. Of course, in DO schools or osteopathic medical schools, you will learn OMM. So technically, you learn more in DO schools, which makes you more equipped to treat patients. I don't want to get into the debate of MD versus DO versus Caribbean medical schools in this video, but it goes without saying that there are some inherent biases by residents and directors, and that is just the world we live in. But I also do believe that just because you went to a non-US MD school, it does not mean that you will not be a great doctor with a great specialty. Your path may be a bit harder or different, but you'll get what you want if you truly want it. You just have to work for it. Lastly, apply as early as possible. It truly affects your chances of getting in. Most schools are in a rolling admission, so you want to have your application in an initial wave of applications. In addition, have your secondary essay prompts pre-written. You want to submit secondaries as soon as possible. I will say definitely within the first week of receiving it if you want to be super high speed. Alright guys, that's all I have for you in this video. Hopefully this was helpful. Please hit the like button and subscribe for more videos. Good luck in your applications and best of luck. You got this. Thank you, and I'll see you on the next video. Bye.